We have seen the rise and fall of the notorious fidget spinners. What will be the next toy to trend throughout the world? Well, there's a couple that seem to be getting a bit of attention right now. In this video, I'd just like to speak a little bit about both of them and how each of these has a potential message for a few things that most of us are probably struggling with in this day and age. Let's start off talking about the fidget spinners briefly. The fidget spinners started off being a toy mainly for children who had autism, but the trend soon became widespread, and then we had children of all ages, even adults, playing with these fidget spinners, and it became quite a big deal. A lot of people, including myself, had quite the infatuation with these little things. And I think it's potentially because quite a few of us struggle with concentration in this day and age. I mean, the fidget spinners were originally designed to help with concentration in young children, but I feel that a lot of us, even adults, find our minds swaying and getting distracted with how much there actually is in the world right now and how much there is to focus on in each of our daily lives. Sometimes it's hard to keep on task, and sometimes I think each of us just needs something simple to just kind of get that release and to get that distraction, that simple distraction that just gets our minds off of everything. And I think that's why the fidget spinners work so well and why so many people like them, including myself. But now that everybody's kind of put their fidget spinners on the shelf, I'm wondering what the next big trend will be. And one of the things my friend was saying is potentially blowing up right now is in Japan they have these really cute squishy toys. I mean, squishy toys have been around like forever, but these cute designed ones with lots of different faces and different types seem to have a new kind of appeal. And it's only very recently that they started to become very trendy in the US, and usually what happens in the US is followed in the UK and various other countries. While doing a tiny bit of research on these new squishy toys, I found an article with the headline, "Adults' Obsession with Weird Squishy Stuffed Animals Reveals a Heartbreaking Need in Our Psyche." I will leave the article in the description of this video. And what this article basically alludes to is that a lot of us are kind of suffering that need for comfort, and that need for just something to hold and to just feel close with, that feeling of security and warmth. And these squishy toys kind of spark that part of our brain which makes us feel warm and nice when we have a hug, and that's potentially why they have caught on so well. It would be really interesting if we do start to see these toys widespread, and then if we do, for example, start to see them become trendy once again with the teens and also with the adults. It does seem like a reoccurring trend that some of the teens or some of these big YouTubers will pick up like a kid's toy and start to use it, and then it starts to become a thing that, you know, becomes normal for people of all ages. Which I don't really necessarily think is such a bad thing, but I just think it also shows how different we've become. Like, it's a lot more acceptable for people of all ages to be playing with different kinds of toys and to be, you know, getting different relief from them for different reasons. So far we've covered the fidget spinners, which helps with attention. These new squishy toys, which helps with a sense of comfort. And finally, I'd like to talk about a little something which isn't really a toy, but it kind of used to be, so that's why I'm going to kind of mention it in this kind of toy category. There used to be these little cool devices called Tamagotchis, and everybody around my era would know all about them. They were a big trend during the 90s. And they were these little toys, usually with like a screen on them, and then you'd have like this little 8-bit pet that you have to take care of, and you have to feed, and you have to make sure that it's okay and everything. And then it would grow and it would change and it would do different things. But a lot of them would just die because people would just forget about them for years, and then they come back and find it dead, which is kind of amusing that they even put that in the little games. But yeah, they're planning on revitalizing this trend and bringing it into mobile apps, which is kind of genius if you ask me. I mean, the first I heard of it was in my Japanese class. Everybody was speaking about it and there was a lot of excitement in the room because it kind of hits that nostalgia button for a lot of people. And Tamagotchis are actually a really cool idea, and I think that now that we have better technology, it's going to be well implemented, and we'll see lots of new ideas probably grow from this. It could be the next big thing. I think it could actually outdo Pokemon Go as far as a mobile phone app trend goes. But once again, this is something which is kind of aimed at children, but I think that also adults are going to kind of go for it as well. Because for one reason, as I said, it's the nostalgia, it's the people who grew up in their childhood owning a Tamagotchi, they want to kind of have that feeling again. But also, I think it's company, and I feel it's that kind of sense of looking after something and feeling close to something. I find it really interesting that each one of these things I've mentioned has all touched on kind of like that human quality that we all need. Like, each of us kind of has that desire for those feelings. Each of us needs focus. Each of us needs comfort, and each of us needs company. And I just find it really interesting that these things which are becoming trendy are touching, I think, parts of our soul. And when you look past the gimmicks and when you look past the flash, I think trends are kind of a double-edged sword, because sometimes they kind of distract us from the real things which really matter. But on the other hand, I think they also make us really aware of what we actually do need and what it is that we're lacking in our lives. But yeah, that's just my thoughts on these things. What do you think about fidget spinners, squishies, Tamagotchis, or the new Tamagotchi app which is coming out? Leave a comment, I'd be really interested to hear what you've got to say. Thanks for watching. Catch you later.